It's an MMA fight in Dublin with Paul Redmond. They got a KSW 44. So Redzer, look, I mean, you've already got a win here under the KSW banner. A lot of people, because obviously your UFC lineage, and you're like, meant to be in the title conversation for Obama, a lot of people saw you as maybe an opponent for Mateusz Gamrot at some stage. Is this a fight where you think if you get a win over Szczesinski, you could be looking at that fight next?
Yeah, I don't think I put enough of a stamp on the fight that I had in KSW first to sort of warrant a title fight, but good win, good solid win over here on Saturday, and I will ask for it. And then the Bama one, that's not here nor there, that's just, I don't know what's down on there. You know what I mean?
Szczesinski's a guy, he's a prospect, so like they're kind of pitting him against an experienced guy like you. He is a lot, like he can get a lot from this win against you. What are you expecting from him?
Hard punches.
He looks like he plants his feet and looks to bang.
Yeah. I think he's over 100 boxing and kickboxing fights combined. So I think he's got 5 or 6 knockouts in his 9 fights at MMA. So I know he's got really, really heavy hands. So it's obviously it's no secret that you have to watch out for that. You know what I mean? But yeah, I'm expecting that. You know, I hope he's fit though, because we're now 155 that long three. You know, I hope he's good for three.
One thing that you've had a problem with throughout your career is calling for things and getting your name out there. Like, I mean, is this one where we could see you maybe say something on the mic afterwards, put your name in place for that title fight?
Yeah, I just, you know, it's not really my nature, and it's probably my downfall to, you know, scream about things or tell fellas I'm going to break them in half and this, that, and the other. At the end of the day, when he's getting into the ring on fight night, he's going to try and kill each other anyways. So this thing of, you know, shoving each other on the stage, on the weighing scale the day beforehand, I think that's absolutely nonsense. All I want to do, after the weigh-in, shake the guy's hand, go get filled. That's it. At the last Bama sort of press conference, there's a bit of argy-bargy with some of the fighters in the press conference, then on the stage. I'm just like, lads, so save it for tomorrow, they're going to kill each other anyway. So I don't know, but I think me and Mateusz match up really well in terms of grappling style. You know, he likes his leg locks and his good brown belt. He's won a lot of things in, I think he's won an ADCC trials and stuff like that over there. So I think stylistically we match up really well. I saw his last 2 normal fights. I thought Norman won the first one by a fraction, and he was obviously winning the second one, but regardless, before that madness happened, I thought he was just pipping Norman to the punch. So I think they've got one and one, so I don't know if they're going to do that again. If that sells it more than I sell it, who knows?
But it's in a situation where like KSW and a lot of people in Poland feel like this guy is the best lightweight outside of the UFC in Europe.
It could very well be, you know.
But he needs tests like you to prove that, right? A guy that's already been at the big guns.
You see, the problem with me being sort of at the UFC and stuff is I didn't register any wins, and I fought in a weight class that I'm not comfortable with. So to me, my tenure in the UFC, it doesn't really... All right, I have the T-shirt to say, oh yeah, I've been there, done that. But because they haven't won or anything like that, I don't see it as that, if that makes sense. So if I went back in at lightweight, I think, you know, beating the guys in there at lightweight, Damian Brown and stuff like that, you know. So I think if I went in and had a better account of myself at lightweight, I think I could sort of scream and shout and make sure I see this, that, and you do that. But at the minute, no, that's sort of where I feel, you know.
You're 4-1 since then, you only lost
At lightweight
since, and obviously the one loss came to Norman Park. There was a lot of debate after that fight. I mean, do you think that's something the UFC might be interesting? Do you still think they have an eye on you, considering your form since then?
Yeah, you know, I was talking to the matchmaker, Sean Shelby, you know, getting back onto anything, they send them emails and stuff like that, and I was talking to the boys at sort of Bellator, and, you know, you're always sort of keeping in contact with these people in case anything does come up. So they just said, all the promoters just said, look, just keep doing what you're doing. That's all I can do at the minute, you know. I can't just show up to the office, you know, give us another shot or this, that, and that. You know, when they want you, they'll come back. But, you know, I'm happy just trying and fighting at the minute. So whatever comes next after this fight, I'm not looking past that anyway. So whatever comes after that, we'll sit down after the fight and have a think about it myself and Andy.
Just to end on a cliche, how do you think this fight's going to go?
I never do them, you know me, PT. I never do them. All I know is I'm fit, super fit, and I've been working everything. And it is cliche, you know. Oh, it's the best camp ever, this, that, and the other. You know, it's not something I'm just going to stand here and say, but I've been working my arse off, and everybody's seen, sort of seen the fruits of my labour since I came out of the UFC. So hopefully it comes across on Saturday night.
And do you fight for the KSW lightweight title before the end of the year?
I don't know. You tell me. You email KSW and ask them. It'd be nice, all right. I know they've got one show lined up maybe at the end of the year. Can't really say anything too much. So as long as I get a win on Saturday, I think the fight Mateusz would line perfectly up for where they've got that on, you know. So we'll see.
Thanks very much, Red.